Celebrate on this, eighth Sunday after Trinity.
God the Father forgives us in Christ and heals us by the Holy Spirit. God, be gracious to us and bless us and make your face shine upon us.
Save us from pride, when we are needy, save us from despair, that we may trust in you alone, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Hands up if you like birthdays. Hands up if you like Christmas Day. Hands up. I just keep my hands up. Hands up if you like getting birthday and Christmas presents. Hands up if you like opening birthday and Christmas presents. Hands up if you like the surprise, not knowing what's going to be in them. Now, be honest. Be absolutely honest. If you've got a present and it's all wrapped up and you pick it up, do you shake it? Do you sort of feel it around, try and work out what it is? Or is part of the excitement not knowing? Because that reading from the Bible we've just heard, in a sense, is a bit like that. It's talking about God as a God who surprises us. Now, it would have been a real surprise if when she'd arrived this morning, I'd said, "Oh, by the way, you're doing the all-age address this morning." That would have been a real surprise, and the look on her face would have been an absolute picture. It would have been very good as well. We never know quite what's going to happen, because God can leap into our lives at all sorts of strange times. We've got to be ready. Now then, one of the ways we were getting ready this morning to ensure that things didn't go completely pear-shaped was to have our lamps lit and ready. Before all of you arrived, there he was, the sacristan, going around with the oil, filling all the candles, making sure that the wicks were just right, ensuring that we were ready for the service. Now, the thing is, we don't know what Jesus is going to be like when he comes back. We don't know what he looks like. We don't know whether actually Jesus is disguised as Allah. That could be Jesus sitting there, having got the lamps ready beforehand. Actually, Jesus could be sitting here. Jesus could be sitting there. Jesus could be me. Jesus might not have come back yet. The point is, we always need to be ready for the unexpected. You weren't ready. You've got to be ready. Always be ready, because you never know when Jesus, the God who surprises us with great joy and great love, is going to burst into our lives. And when he does, that's the best birthday or Christmas present you can have. The best thing to be able to unwrap. Power of the Spirit and in union with Christ, let us pray to the Father. We are the body of Christ. In the one Spirit, we are all baptized into one. Let us then pursue all that makes for peace and builds up our common life. Peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you. Let us offer each other a sign of Christ's peace.
Thank you.
make yourself known in the breaking of bread. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Give us this great and beautiful earth to discover and to cherish. And now we give you thanks, because you are the source of light and life. You made us in your image and called us to new life in Christ. You made us all, each wonderfully different, to join with the angels and sing your praise. Thank you, loving Father, because when we turned away, you sent Jesus your Son. He gave his life for us on the cross and shows us the way to him. Send your Holy Spirit, that these gifts of bread and wine may be for us Christ's body and his blood. On the night before he died, when darkness had fallen, Jesus took bread. He gave thanks, broke, and shared it with his disciples, saying, "This is my body, given for you. Do this to remember me." After they had eaten, he took the cup of wine, gave thanks, and shared it with his disciples, saying, "This is my blood, poured out for you and for men, for the forgiveness of sins." This cup, we celebrate his love, his death, his risen life. As you feed us with these gifts, send your Holy Spirit and change us more and more to be like Jesus our Savior. Help us, Father, to love one another as we look forward to that day when suffering is ended and all creation gathered in your loving arms. now with all your saints, we give you glory through Jesus Christ, in the strength of the Spirit, today and forever. Jesus taught us to call God our Father. So in faith and love we pray together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, for we all share in one bread. Jesus, Lamb of God, have mercy on us. Jesus, bearer of our sins, have mercy. Jesus is the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those who are called to his supper. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. God of truth, we have seen with our eyes and touched with our hands the bread of life. Strengthen our faith that we may grow in love for you and for each other, through Jesus Christ our risen Lord. Amen. The notices are very, very straightforward. They are really as printed in the newsletter. One thing just to draw to your attention, particularly those who've been here a few years, Father Dave Billett, the priest in charge at St Barnabas, Sutton. Legal things have happened with parishes in Sutton. St Barnabas is now a parish in its own right, and Father Dave will be inducted as vicar of St Barnabas, because he's been priest in charge. He's now going to be the vicar, and that's going to be on the 30th of August at 7 o'clock at St Barnabas, and he does invite friends from All Saints to join him for that. If you would like to go, if you could just let us know over the next couple of weeks so that we can let them know what rough ideas of numbers might be. Please do stay for refreshments after Mass, and if you're here and need to indicate your presence for a place at school, don't forget to sign the book as you leave. And of course, there are the two contactless points for donations by both doors as well. I think that those are all the notices. Please stand for the blessing. The Lord. Christ, who has nourished us with himself, the living bread, make you one in praise and love, and raise you up at the last day. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be upon you and remain with you all. Amen.